Mr. President, friends and fellow citizens, the papers and the placards say that I am to deliver a 4th of July oration. But neither their familiar faces nor the perfect gauge I think I have at Corinthian Hall seems to free me from embarrassment. The fact is, ladies and gentlemen, the distance between this platform and the slave plantation from which I escaped is considerable, and the difficulties to be overcome in getting from the latter to the former are by no means slight. That I am here today is to me a matter of astonishment as well as of gratitude. You will not, therefore, be surprised if in what I have to say. With little experience and with less learning, I have been able to throw my thoughts hastily and imperfectly together, and trusting to your patience and generous indulgence, I will proceed to lay them before you. This, for the purpose of this celebration, is the 4th of July. It is the birthday of your national independence and your political freedom. This, to you, is what the Passover was to the emancipated people of Yah. It carries your minds back to the day and to the act of your great deliverance and to the signs and to the wonders associated with that act and that day. My business, if I have any here today, is with the present. The accepted time with Yah and his cause is the ever-living now. Trust no future, however pleasant. Let the dead past bury its dead. Act, act in the living present, heart within and Yah overhead. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is oft-entered with their bones. What have I or those I represent to do with your national independence? Fellow citizens, pardon me, allow me to ask, why am I called upon to speak here today? What have I or those I represent to do with your national independence? Are the great principles of the political freedom and of natural justice embodied in that Declaration of Independence extended to us? And am I, therefore, called upon to bring our humble offering to the national altar and to confess the benefits and express devout gratitude for the blessings resulting from your independence to us? Would it to Yah, both for your sakes and ours, that an affirmative answer could be truthfully returned to these questions? Then why would my task be light and my burden easy and delightful? For who is there so cold that a nation's sympathy cannot warm him? Who so obdurate and dead to the claims of gratitude that would not thankfully acknowledge such priceless benefits? Who so stolid and selfish that would not give his voice to swell the hallelujahs of a nation's jubilee? When the chains of servitude have been torn from his limbs, I am not that man. In a case like that, the dumb might eloquently speak, and the lame man leap as a hart. But such is not the state of the case. I say it with a sad sense of disparity between us. I am not included within the pale of this glorious anniversary. Your high independence only reveals the immeasurable distance between us. The blessings in which you this day rejoice are not enjoyed in common. The rich inheritance of your justice, liberty, prosperity, and independence bequeathed by your fathers is shared by you, not me. The sunlight that brought life and healing to you has brought stripes and death to me. This 4th of July is yours, not mine. You may rejoice, I must mourn. To drag a man in fetters into the grand illuminated temple of liberty and call upon him to join you in joyous anthems were inhuman and mockery and sacrilegious irony. Do you mean, citizens, to mock me by asking me to speak today? If so, there's a parallel to your conduct. And let me warn you that it is dangerous to copy the example of a nation whose crimes, lowering up to heaven, were thrown down by the breath of the Almighty, burying that nation in irrecoverable ruin. I can today take up the plaintive lament of a peeled and woe-smitten people. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yeah, we wept when we remembered Zion. We hanged our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there, they that carried us away captive required of us a song. And they who wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of those songs of Zion. How can we sing the master's song in a strange land? If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget her cunning. If I do not remember thee, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. Fellow citizens, above your national tumultuous joy, I hear the mournful wail of millions, whose chains, heavy and grievous yesterday, are today rendered more intolerable by the jubilee shouts that reach them. If I do forget, if I do not faithfully remember those bleeding children of sorrow this day, may my right hand forget her cunning, and may my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. To forget them, to pass lightly over their wrongs, and to chime in with the popular theme would be treason, most scandalous and shocking, and would make me a reproach before Yah and the world. For the present, it is enough to affirm the equal manhood of the Negro race. Is it not astonishing that while we are plowing, planting, and reaping, using all kinds of mechanical tools, erecting houses, constructing bridges, building ships, working in metals of brass, iron, copper, silver, and gold, that while we are reading, writing, and ciphering, acting as clerks, merchants, and secretaries, having among us lawyers, doctors, ministers, poets, authors, editors, orators, and teachers, that while we are engaged in all manners of enterprises common to other men, digging gold in California, capturing a whale in the Pacific, feeding sheep and cattle in the hillside, living, mowing, acting, thinking, planning, living in families as husbands, wives, and children, above all confessing and worshiping the Christian's God, and looking hopefully for life and immortality beyond the grave, we are called upon to prove that we are men. Would you have me argue that man is entitled to liberty? That he is rightful owner of his own body? You have already declared it. Must I argue the wrongfulness of slavery? What to the American slave is your 4th of July? I answer, a day that reveals him more than all other than the year, the gross injustice and cruelty to which he is constant victim. To him, your celebration is a sham. Your boasted liberty and unholy license, your national greatness, swelling vanity, your sounds of rejoicing are empty and heartless. Your denunciations of tyrants, brass-fronted impudence, your shouts of liberty and equality, hollow mockery. Your prayers and hymns, your sermons and thanksgivings, with all your religious parade and solemnity, are to him mere bombast, fraud, deception, impiety, and hypocrisy. A thin veil to cover up crimes which you would disgrace a nation of savages. There is not a nation on earth guilty of practices more shocking and bloody than are the people of this United States at this very hour. Go where you may, search where you will, roam through all the monarchies and despotisms of the old world. Travel through South America. Search out every abuse. And when you have found the last, lay your facts by the side of the everyday practices of this nation. And you will say with me that for revolting barbarity and shameless hypocrisy, America reigns without a rival. Hallelujah. Frederick Douglass. July 5th.